Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Jason. I'm going to blow your mind with what I found in this KitKat commercial.
Boo!
I'm sorry for what I did to your face.
All good. Have a break. Have a break. Have a KitKat.
When I initially watched this commercial, I really didn't think there was going to be that much to talk about, but there's much more than the eye can see. Objectively, you can see that there's a woman who messes up on her pumpkin carving, then the pumpkin comes alive, spooks her, and gives her a KitKat. All of this is done at night with low lighting because that's where Halloween is spookiest, at night. And they did it inside of a kitchen because that's where you'd probably cut up a pumpkin. Subjectively though, there's more to the story, and I have evidence to prove it. Let's assume this lady is a mother because of the decorations on the refrigerator, and a wife because of the ring on her finger. That makes me wonder why she's doing all the decorating on her own. Then the pumpkin comes alive, the lady apologizes, and the pumpkin tells her to have a break. So what does all of this really mean? Today, a normal attribute for women is to have a job by day and be a mother and a wife by night. So the duty of decorating is probably on her, and since it's at night, she probably already worked a full day, she already made dinner, and now she's doing the rest of the decorations by herself. So I'm assuming that she's tired, and when you're tired, you make mistakes.
I'm sorry for what I did to your face.
All good.
The pumpkin is personified and tells her to take
a break,
which is telling all women that identify with this lady to go and relax, take a break, and have a KitKat. You did a lot of work, you did it all on your own, so KitKat might be recognizing women for their hard work. Plus, there's studies that indicate that chocolate helps to reduce stress. At my previous job, I developed a habit of eating too much chocolate, and when you looked at my desk, you could tell how stressed I was because there was shrapnel of the wrappers just lying all over the desk, and then people would end up calling me Candywitz. That was my nickname, Candywitz. But I was the hookup for all the other people that were stressed. Funny enough, ever since I left my previous employer, I really have not had any urges to eat chocolate because I'm not stressed. I'm not stressed because I have my own company. My only bosses that I have are my clients now. But anyway, who is the target market in this commercial? Honestly, anyone that's participating in the Halloween holiday. I already insinuated that the people that are doing a lot of work and doing everything on their own are just stressing out. They need to take a break, and what better way to take a break with a KitKat? So they should have KitKats while they're decorating, they should have KitKats while they're at work because of stress, and they should have KitKats for the trick-or-treaters. And in case you missed it, there's a subliminal message at the end of the commercial where the mummy arm puts its hand into the bowl and grabs out a bunch of KitKats. That's a subliminal message, and when you see it enough, eventually it starts to make you think subliminally that you should start taking KitKats all the same. So it has to happen a lot of times. There's something called AIDA, which I'm not going to go into, but you can look that up, A-I-D-A. So what was the objective of this commercial? Well, KitKat is a well-known brand. They don't really have to inform you about what the product is like. They don't have to persuade you to buy it. You already know a ton of things about the regular KitKat, likely. So all they're doing is reminding you that they're around. They still want you to stay with them. They don't want you to go to other competitors. They want you to eat their chocolate. I like KitKat, I'm not affiliated with them, but I definitely had a lot of KitKats on my desk filled with shrapnel at my previous employer though, not anymore. But they're reminding you to take a break with KitKats. And lastly, what do we have here? An unexplained random line. Gotcha. Looks like it came from the pumpkin and it was missed in that one clip. And that's all I have for today. If you would like me to review a commercial of your choosing, go check out the details in the description. Otherwise, go comment, go like, and most of all, go subscribe because I post videos every Wednesday.